Hey, I'm Dinis. Welcome to my channel DMaker. This video is the first part of a series called Do-It-Yourself Table Saw, where I will turn a cheap table saw into a bigger, stronger and more reliable one in order to be more accurate and cut wider boards. In this first part, I will make the enclosure and the lifting system. Stay tuned to see the final result. This is the table saw I had, and as you can see, it's small, unstable, and the fence is really wobbly. I will start by dismantling the table saw in order to remove what I need, which is the motor and some rods and brackets. For that, I have to lower the blade and turn it upside down to remove the mechanical and electrical components. Most of this is plastic, which I will try to avoid in the new table saw. After removing the saw from the cabinet, I still need to strip off some parts. Some of the parts will be used later on, but most of them will not be necessary. After dismantling the saw, I start the assembly of the new one, and for that I use 18mm Baltic birch plywood, which I cut the size off camera. The first thing to do is the structure holding the motor, which will be cut to the shape of the motor so that it fits perfectly in order to avoid most of the vibrations. I used a jigsaw and then some rasps and files to get to the final shape. Since the upper part is too narrow, I decided to reinforce it using a piece of aluminum. Now I connect this part to the motor in order to adjust the alignment, making sure everything fits. On one of the sides, I used the already existing taproot holes to fix it with bolts. On the other side, I had to drill the metal and tap it with an M4 tap, so that I can use two more bolts.
In order to allow the vertical movement of the saw, I used linear rails and bearings. I marked the location of the bearings in the side pieces and drilled them together so that the position is the same. In order to connect the parts together with wood screws, I improvised the jig in my bench to avoid misalignments. I did not use any glue so that I can disassemble it in the future. It's now time to make the back piece using the same technique, except that this time I could not outline the exact shape. So I decided to draw an oval by hand, which reminded me of my school times. I then fixed the sides to the structure and the linear bearings in the pre-drilled holes. For the outer box, I start by installing the linear rails on the sides. I then connect the linear rails to the bearings, aligned everything, and assembled the base and backside. After installing the threaded rod that will allow the movement of the saw, I realized that it's not very stable and decided to add an extra nut. For that, I made a small rebate with a chisel to fit one edge of the nut, while nailing some plywood to the sides to keep it from moving sideways. In the bottom of the plastic gear, I use the bearing sitting on a piece of plywood. The brackets, rods and plastic gears I use are all from the original table saw mechanism, but installed in a different way. The rod is connected to the bottom using a bolt. I added a bearing to allow the bolt to move together with the rod. After testing the proper alignment, it's time to fix the bracket that holds the horizontal rod to the bottom of the structure. It seems that everything is working fine, it's only missing some lubrication. For that, I use the silicon-based lubricant in the plastic gears and lithium grease in the metal parts. For the front cover, I measured the saw in both positions and cut the plywood leaving space to install the riving knife later on. This part of the front cover will serve as a stopper when the saw reaches its lower limit. Finally, I fixed the front cover with wood screws and made a hole for the electric cable.
The lifting system worked out great and the structure holding the saw is now much more stable. It can still be improved by replacing the plastic gears that came with the table saw with metal ones, but for now I think it's okay. I hope you liked the video and consider subscribing so that you don't miss the next parts where I will be making the tilting system, the tabletop, the fence and some nice accessories. Thanks for watching and remember, you can build it.